Oscar's the only undefeated one at the moment.
Yeah.
Does he ever point that out?
Nah, he doesn't.
Nah.
Hopefully he stays that way.
Yeah.
He will, though. It would be exciting when all three of us fight in the same card, though.
You guys never done that?
In amateurs.
In amateurs?
Yeah.
Pros, not? Never? Pros, never?
What? Nah, never.
You guys ever talk about that?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah?
But it'd be nice if it does happen.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it will once Carlos gets back on it.
Yeah.
He's been injured right now. He's got to let his elbow heal up 100% and then he'll get back on it.
It's a trip. A trip all the Molinas are going
to
make
to
the fight?
For sure.
All of Norway. All of Norway's going to be there.
All of Norway. Hopefully we get all of Norway out there on this next fight in LA.
Yeah. You guys have a lot of support, though. You really do. Like, in Norwalk, is not the support you guys get is not normal.
Yeah, it's cool having that support right there in Norwalk.
Yeah.
A lot of people writing to us, and a lot of people will write to me too for the from that documentary they made on us.
Yeah.
Me and my brother
little
from Born and Bred.
Yeah,
so we always get a lot of little kids or people just writing to us. You know, thank them for inspiring them. And you know. When they write to me like that, you know, I appreciate the support. I'm happy I'm able to inspire somebody out there with my story. So hopefully I keep going at it and inspire more people when I become a world champion.
What do you recall from that whole documentary?
Oh, it was cool. They started, Justin Framer was on that filmed the whole thing. We started following them when we were like 14, 15 years old. I forgot exactly how old we were. 14, 15, all the way. It led up to when I made the Olympic team.
Yeah.
So, you know, he recorded like all throughout my whole struggle making the Olympic team. Because it wasn't easy for me. I had to fight a lot. I lost a few times. You know, it was a long road, but it's cool to go back and be able to watch everything that happened and how everything played out. You know, it's a good memory to have.
You look back at it, is it kind of shocking what you put yourself through to get to this point?
Not so much shocking because I'm still trying to do that right now.
Yeah.
But
that little success you had in amateurs is not average, you know.
Yeah.
Not everyone accomplishes what you guys did in amateurs. So.
Yeah, and it took a lot of hard work. And it does, even myself now, like even when I see it. Since I'm going to see it myself and I get inspired myself, like, man,
yeah.
It just motivates me more. And I just try to put that extra effort into becoming a world champion, my next fighter. Like, when I see it, it motivates me. So
when you watch it at times, you don't even realize that's you in there.
Yeah.
It's just kind of like, you get chills, like, man, who's this little kid?
Yeah, even, I'm telling you, even when I watch and I see that I won the Olympic trials or I qualified for the Olympic trials and I see it, I still get, like, goosebumps. You know, just thinking back those days. And you know, I'm still working towards accomplishing my other dream, which is becoming a world champion in the professional ranks.
Yeah.
So,
if you could fight one world champion right now in your division, who would it be?
I don't know. I don't really like calling names out. Anybody. I don't care. Whoever it is.
Anybody can get it.
Anybody can get it.